Do you feel that it's still possible for Balkan EU integration under the existing narrative?
Yes, it is possible. It is advisable. I do think that the current European Union narrative is what the European Union narrative has to maintain for itself. So the Balkans have to adapt to it. The problem is that the European Union has to find strong new allies in society. So it has to grow new actors in society that abide by these ideas, these views. We don't have to drop that to integrate the Balkans. The Balkans have to will be better places, better countries for their citizens when they will move ahead into the European Union direction.
Can the EU afford to let the Balkans shift towards Russia, Turkey and China?
I think it can afford it. The Balkans should know it. Playing the geopolitical card is not useful for them. It risks to confine the Balkans to a lower marginal position. Of course, there is a risk for the European Union. You don't want to have any one of these external power influencing political processes in the region, but they already do it with member states. So there is no reason why the European Union should be more concerned of Chinese interference in European policy making using Greece, or that is a member state, rather than Serbia. So somehow the risk can be taken. The Balkans should be aware instead that they are the one who will lose the game if they don't take seriously the integration process.
To what degree has Balkan integration stalled due to European mismanagement?
I don't think there is a European mismanagement. What was lost, it was the momentum. There were major political challenges for European Union, starting with the financial crisis in 2008. This reflected negatively on the integration process. We had the so-called integration fatigue, this idea that we already had many other problems to deal with. So somehow the Balkans lost the train, if you want, the train that Croatia instead had taken in right time, and Croatia became a member in 2013 because it had achieved already all the steps required right in time. The rest of the region had lost the train because they were lagging behind in reforms, because they were lost in political confrontation, because they were not handing in war criminals. The European Union at the point was overwhelmed by its own problem. At that point, yes, indeed, new actors came in, and this created a new political climate, a new challenge, the fight for hegemony in the region. But I don't think what now it is going on is an effort to relaunch the process. Psychologically or emotionally, politically, rather than in terms of management. The management should not change. It has already a very clear path design. I think it only has to be consistent and hopefully achieve the goal. Certainly, in order to achieve the goal, the European Union needs to find stronger allies at local level, create more alliances with actors in civil society in particular that can sustain the effort of the European Union and change, transform these countries, do the judicial reforms, the anti-corruption norms, the necessary reforms that are in place for these countries to become member states.